has its own prescription on how development should take place, and the global model of childhood. When I say the global model of childhood, I'm referring to a once localized Western construction of childhood that has been exported to the rest of the world through education, through interventions of non-governmental organizations, through the works of missionaries, through colonialism. And these ideas have a focus on three important dimensions. First, childhood is seen as a period where children should be protected from many things, from work, for example. Again, we will explore in greater depth about this idea of protection. Again, this Western construction of childhood tends to view children as dependents, right? Childhood as dependents on parents, on adults, on families and communities. But if you really look at the reality of children's lives in Africa, children are not necessarily mere dependents. Of course they are dependents, but we all are also dependents on each other. We are interdependent. Nobody is independent. Everybody is interdependent. The degree of dependence and independence can vary. However, children and childhood is not just a depending phase of the life course. There is so much to the life works of children that we can say, particularly in the context of Africa. And if you really look at some of the paradigm shift that has taken place in the 1980s, 1990s, actually, it took place because researchers began to observe the lives of children in Africa, how children are engaged in a wide range of social, economic, and cultural activities. It made researchers realize that children are actually social actors. They are not mere dependents on families and communities. They are interdependent human beings, and that is very central. And the third dimension is this increasing institutionalization of childhood, a focus that is being placed on schooling. Again, a topic that we're going to explore in a greater depth in these institutes. So, and then the final parallel that I would like to focus on is that of futurity and becoming. Now, Africa is seen as a place which is in the making, right? Things are happening in Africa. Okay, African countries are being democratized. Huh? They will catch up, they will be there. In Africa, economic development is taking place, you know? There are a lot of investment that are going on here and there. Africa is seen as a place, as a site of intervention. It is seen as a continent which is in the making, as a continent which is not finished, which for me is a problematic. In much the same way as children are also viewed as future becomings, as future adults. And so these are some of the things that I would like us to really engage with more fully. And so in recent decades, there has been some advances in the ways in which children have been theorized, children have been conceptualized, children have been written about. And this conceptualization largely comes from interdisciplinary perspectives of what is known as the social studies of children and childhood. And this is in many ways a break away from developmental psychology, which saw childhood as a natural phenomena. There was a need to focus on the social worlds of children, right? So it was in many ways an epistemology, it was a paradigm shift, it was an epistemological and methodological break. I say it is an epistemological and methodological break because it suggested four core ideas. The first idea is a recognition that children are social actors. They have agency. Children are not mere passive recipients of development interventions. They have in many ways a contribution to make, a meaningful contribution to make to their families and communities. And then the second is the idea that it is necessary to study children's experiences and life worlds in its own right. Because in traditional ideas of, for example, in socialization theories, the understanding is that children are socialized to families and communities. Their role in influencing and shaping the process of socialization is not really given important consideration. And then the third dimension is that of viewing children in the here and now, in the present moment, rather than focusing about the adults that the children will become. It was seen necessary to focus on the lived experience of children in the present moment, in the here and now. So oftentimes you see in the literature a debate between understanding children as human beings in the here and now, or viewing them as future adult becomings, so-called the being becoming binary. And like I tried to allude to later on, it's also important to bring into the picture the history of childhood, the being child. So the being child, the being child, and the becoming child are very central for us to have a fuller understanding of the lives of children. And in that understanding, one of the core suggestions that scholars have come up in the late 1980s was this idea that it is necessary to find ways of engaging children in the research process, because children are not just social actors. They not only have agency, but they also have knowledge. They have valid knowledge, they have valid perspectives that they can share us to researchers. So there was a need to have this bottom-up approach in research, a bottom-up approach in knowledge production with children, not on children or about children. So there was a need to have perspectives, knowledge, and ideas of children incorporated in the process of knowledge production. So this kind of gives you some introductory ideas about some of the issues that we will return to, I'm very sure, in greater detail during the course of these 2 weeks. And I will now open the floor for questions and discussions, okay? All right, thank you.